Having spent the day shopping for a new dinette set, the Big Cheese now partakes of his favorite pastime, eating sushi while disguised as a traveling cosmetic saleswoman.
But say, my. The nice thing about sushi is I can eat all I want to and still keep my girlish figure.
I was just gonna say that. Say, would you like to take in a movie later?
No, thank you. Prepare an order to go for me, will ya? And don't forget the soy sauce.
What a glutton. And he didn't even invite me to join him. Just wait till he asks me to cook the turkey next Thanksgiving. What are you yo-yo staring at? Oh, my socks don't match.
Keep it simple. Just give me two of everything and throw in an order of rock seaweed, will ya?
Having satisfied his elementary lusts, the Big Cheese turned his thoughts to business.
By the way, Jerry, how is the construction of the Samurai Stomper progressing? Are we on schedule? I hope so.
Our latest robot weapon is almost complete.
I can't wait to use it, Jerry. Little Tokyo is ours.
Look out!
Hey, what's going on? Why are we stopping?
Father!
Farther? Did he say farther? How can we go any farther with you idiots standing in the road?
Let go, you silly thing. Let go! Don't you understand? This foolish creature thinks I'm its father.
Father! Father!
Go play in the traffic. Believe me, I'm not this wretched child's father.
Could this be true? The child seems so sure. If it is, this could cause quite a scandal.
Extra, extra, Big Cheese finds baby and becomes doting father. Council sources reveal he's going to adopt more children and open a daycare center. Extra!
Who cares? Give me the sports section!
Hey! This story about cheese is unbelievable.
I think you should put that in to boost the circulation.
Maybe, but if it's true, Big Cheese and his cadre will be out of the bad guy business, and little Tokyo will be safe from evil.
Yeah, they'll be too busy changing diapers. We won't have to fight them anymore.
We can get out of these ridiculous outfits.
What are we waiting for?
Oh, we'll have time. I can go back to school and study nuclear reactors like my Uncle Irving.
We'll have time for girls.
We'll have wild parties every night.
Yeah! You're dreaming if you think you're going to split and leave us knee-deep in pizza and pasta. Now get in that kitchen and start cooking pronto. All you can think of is girls. What are Polly and I, chop liver? That's his name, sweetie. Don't wear it out. This baby you've adopted is a precocious little fella, isn't he?
I haven't adopted him.
Yes. He's my daddy.
No, Princess Bot.
Oh, pipe down, Seymour. Now, what shall we name him? Seymour Jr.
No, I won't have this jabbering creature named after me.
That's what you think. Well, that's settled. The child's name shall be Seymour Jr. Now we should talk about this daycare center. The Emperor and I both think that it's a busy idea.
Oh, no. Where's the baby?
Red, Red. Cheese, you better learn to control that child.
Give me that baby back. You're scaring him. Cheese.
Now, Seymour, look at how well you're handling him. You're changing his diaper and he's not even squawking. I think you should open up a diaper cleaning service as well as a daycare center.
Huh? You're crazy.
He called her crazy.
So what? She is crazy.
Your Royal Highness, we all wholly support your decision. So would you like to make the declaration now?
Chief, this child is officially yours. I declare it. Also, I order you to open a daycare center and diaper cleaning service at once.
What about my seat on the council.
Oh, you have to quit the council.
Your Highness, oh, no.
Crab.
Daycare center. Hey, I'm hungry. Get up, Horsey. Run!
Listen, Ken, will you stop kicking? You're killing me.
Who'd have thought there'd be so many diapers here in Little Tokyo? My hands are getting chapped from doing laundry. Ooh, I can't stand the smell. Dramatic, huh? Think I'll win an Oscar this year? At least I have my secret laboratory at which to take solace from this miserable situation.
I hope our fearless leader can get these kids potty trained.
Well, Jerry, how's it going down here?
Go away. I'm folding.
The new robot. Jerry, is it done?
Are you kidding, Seymour? We're 3 days behind schedule. See? I've got half my Ninja Crow crew on laundry detail.
We must turn this situation to our advantage. I'm surrounded by inefficiency. Here. Take these plans and complete the robot immediately.
Can't we invest in one of those industrial-sized washing machines?
No.
How about hiring some out-of-work sanitary engineers to handle the overload?
No. No, outsiders. They'll tell the pizza cats what we're up to. Stop poking. Will you cut it out?
I was just trying to illustrate a point.
What point was that?
Who's going to finish the laundry?
Never mind the dirty laundry, Jerry. I want that robot in working condition by tonight. If it's not, you're going to be sorry.
Thinking the big cheese was now stuck in the baby business, Speedy planned to take some quality time.
I think I'll pay a visit to Lucille. Haven't gone to Las Vegas for a while. We'll rent the honeymoon suite.
We'll order the best champagne and caviar.
Speedy! Oh, hi, Sylvia. What can I do for you? Huh? Is something wrong, Sylvia?
He's missing. My boy was kidnapped yesterday.
Holy mackerel.
Not wanting to starve the little fella, despite his propensity for soiling diapers, Cheese assigned Bad Bird the task of mixing Seymour Jr.'s lunch, unaware that the precocious brat was about to make a startling discovery.
Maybe we can get the robot to finish the laundry.
Yes! Big Cheese and Geriatric had personally put the finishing touches on the Samurai Stomper. No, it couldn't wash an iron baby bunting, but it could prove to be the most fearsome weapon yet unleashed on Little Tokyo, if controlled by the wrong pair of hands.
What? Sylvia's baby's been kidnapped? When did this happen, Speedy?
Yesterday, while they were shopping.
We went to the big sale at Bimble's department store.
Hey, I read about that sale. Men's underwear was marked down 50%.
I know, I bought you some. Hope you like stripes.
What in the blazes is that?
It sure isn't the dinner bell.
Lucille was right. It wasn't the dinner bell. It was the Samurai Stomper, and he wasn't exactly on an urban redevelopment project.
Daddy, be proud of baby Seymour. Proud. I checked out his new toys.
The kids.